Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching Today I Found Out, and in the video today we're answering a viewer question. Dee Braxton asks, is it safe to eat moldy bread or moldy cheese? But just before we get started, I do want to say that this video is brought to you by TunnelBear. TunnelBear makes really simple privacy apps to help you browse a more open internet. You can try TunnelBear for free when you visit tunnelbear.com/brainfood. Alright, so for the quick answer on whether or not it's safe to eat moldy bread or moldy cheese, the answer is, well, no, and sometimes, respectively. While not all molds are bad for you to eat, many are, and unless you want to whip out a microscope and meticulously identify the mold present on your food, note there are about 300,000 known types and counting, as a general rule, it's better to avoid moldy foods. Not all molds that are bad for you will cause apparent symptoms right away either. For instance, many molds produce aflatoxin, which is a substance that will up your chances of getting cancer and may cause a variety of other health problems for you, though not necessarily right away. That being said, sometimes it is okay to cut off the mold and eat what's underneath. As to when it's okay to eat moldy foods and when it's not, well, that largely depends on the food item. With regard to bread and cheese, it's important to understand that the visible mold you see on the surface of the bread and cheese also sends root threads down into the food. In molds that are bad for you, these threads often have poisonous substances in and around these roots. With hard cheeses, the mold has trouble penetrating deeply into the cheese. As such, you can cut a couple of centimeters of cheese off from each side and discard the moldy slices, and it should be safe to eat. Do note here that just scraping off the visible mold is not good enough. You must cut deeply in to make sure you're getting rid of the runners. Thus, hard or semi-hard cheeses like cheddar, Colby, Gorgonzola, Gruyere, Parmesan, Romano, Stilton, and Swiss, among others, are completely fine to cut the moldy part away and eat what's underneath. Soft cheese like brie, camembert, cottage cheese, cream cheese, or ricotta you should throw out if you notice mold on them. In addition to that, any shredded or crumbled cheese, regardless of type, should always be discarded if you discover mold. All that being said, some cheese is made with mold, such as the aforementioned brie, roquefort, and camembert. Obviously, the mold that the cheese is made with is safe to eat, but if you notice other mold growing on cheese, either cut it off or throw it away, depending on whether it's hard or soft cheese. Now, with bread, you should always throw away the bread if you discover mold on it. Even though in a solid loaf you could easily cut off a couple of inches of the moldy part, unfortunately, because bread is so porous, the mold has no trouble spreading its runner threads throughout the bread's innards. This is very much unlike the situation with hard cheese. In the case of sliced bread, you also usually should throw away the whole loaf. Mold spreads amazingly fast, so if you see one spot of mold, it's likely that the other bread in the package also has mold on it, even if you can't see it yet. The same goes for shredded cheese. One spot of mold visible likely means that it has also spread to the entire package of shredded cheese. So, as a general rule, if the food item is hard, hard cheese, hard fruits and vegetables, etc., and has mold, it's usually alright to cut off some of the food item and eat what's underneath, particularly when there is low moisture content in the food item. Soft fruits and vegetables like strawberries, oranges, green beans, etc., should be thrown out when mold is discovered. For semi-soft food items or hard items with a high moisture content, as a general rule, when these items turn moldy, when in doubt, throw it out. So I really hope you enjoyed that video. Now do bear in mind that the holidays are approaching, and maybe there's someone in your life who loves their privacy. Maybe they're always guarding their passwords carefully and have a 14-digit PIN on their iPhone. Maybe they think biometrics are not real security. Well, if a panic room for this person is not in your gift budget, well then you should check out TunnelBear. It can be given as a gift. TunnelBear, it might not help them from being tracked down by black vans, but it will stop people tracking them on the internet. TunnelBear is an easy-to-use privacy tool that uses secure end-to-end encryption to make sure that what goes on in your tunnel stays in your tunnel. Sign up now and get around unfair geo-based pricing, and stay safe when doing your Christmas shopping online. You can try a free trial of TunnelBear and help support our show by going to tunnelbear.com/brainfood, and you'll find a link in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching.